use of a dangerous weapon. This is the initial appearance of a DA's warrant. This case is assigned to Judge Feist in Branch 46. Appearances, please.
The state's represented by Assistant DA Carino Byrne.
Mr. Parker Bell appears via Zoom from the Criminal Justice Facility with Attorney Angel Johnson. His address is listed on the criminal complaint. His telephone number has been provided in the Zoom chat. He is public defender eligible. We have received a copy of the criminal complaint and we waive its formal reading.
All right, thank you. Mr. Parker Bell, I've read this criminal complaint and I do find that it contains probable cause. You have the right to a lawyer and you qualify for representation. So one will be appointed to represent you. These are felony charges, so you have the right to a preliminary hearing and that will be scheduled for you. I also must advise you of maximum penalties. Count one is the attempt first degree intentional homicide, use of a dangerous weapon. If convicted, you could face 65 years imprisonment. Counts two through eight are first degree recklessly endangering safety with use of a dangerous weapon. And as charged, you could face a $25,000 fine, 17 and a half years imprisonment for each of those counts. Do you understand the penalty, sir?
Yes, ma'am.
All right. Certain charges require that a sample of your DNA be taken when you are arrested. This complaint has those charges. I see that the Milwaukee County Sheriff's Department has a sample of your DNA. I now advise you, you may qualify to have your DNA sample expunged from the DNA bank at the end of the case if you meet certain requirements under the statute. Simply check with your lawyer at the end to see if your DNA can be removed or not. Understood?
Yes.
Okay. I'm gonna turn to and set bail now. We have a risk assessment tool in Milwaukee County I use. You have one prior misdemeanor, negligent handling of a firearm. Your failure to appear of two, new criminal activity of three. However, these charges are what we call step two. And step two charges, by virtue of their seriousness, always have a recommendation of cash level five and GPS monitoring. State, what is your recommendation as to bail?
Thank you, Commissioner. The state is going to support the pretrial risk assessment here. The state is requesting $500,000 cash bail. And I want to start with that endangering safety by use of a dangerous weapon from 2019 CM 4045. In that case, which was just resolved less than a year ago, he accidentally, while playing with a firearm, shot an eight-year-old girl, and she had to go in and have surgery. And thankfully, she survived. And as a consequence of resolving that case, he knows what can happen with a firearm. And in fact, Judge Corey Ashley even made him eligible for expungement if he went a full year without further criminal activity. And he hadn't. Here, less than a year after being sentenced on that serious gun case, he takes a firearm into District 5 police station. And everything is captured on video surveillance. There's the full confession from this defendant. He's facing extremely long exposure to incarceration. And that is a strong motive to flee. Thankfully here, no one was injured. And the risk assessment properly places him at the very highest level of risk and recommends cash bail. And we are, based on that history, recommending $500,000 cash bail.
All right. Do you have any non-monetary conditions you're asking for?
No.
Okay.
Well, no weapons, obviously.
Okay. All right. Defense?
And at this time, we do understand that this will be a cash bailed case. We're asking for no more than a $50,000 cash bail for Mr. Parker Bell, given the nature of these charges. Overall, Mr. Parker Bell has significant ties to the Milwaukee area. He was born and raised here. He graduated from Bradley Tech High School. He was working at Battery Plus when this incident had occurred and living with his significant other, his girlfriend of 3 years. He's someone who, given both the criminal complaint and what he had told police officers, was going through an intense emotional state and has mental health issues. He has, since being taken into custody, has done a significant amount of work on his behalf to try to continue addressing his mental health needs. This situation did arise from the death at the Milwaukee County District 5 police station. And given the fact that Mr. Parker Bell has only had a conviction for a misdemeanor, that 2019 case, and given the fact that he has significant ties to the Milwaukee area and is public defender eligible, we're just requesting no more than the $50,000 cash bail for him.
All right, thank you. Mr. Parker Bell, you know that you're an extreme bail risk. I think that's pretty evident based on the actions. I mean, nobody's kidding anybody here. Majority of the public don't carry a gun and go in to address an issue and then fire it. And I mean, as I read this, you were hoping they'd fire back, law enforcement would, and end your own life. So there's mental health issues clearly, but you're a substantial bail risk. I am going to follow the state's recommendation. You've got 8 serious felonies here. I am going to order $500,000 cash bail to assure your appearance in court. I'm going to order level 5 supervision. And Mr. Parker Bell, I'm ordering absolutely no firearms. You cannot possess any guns as a condition of bail. And we will set this for preliminary hearing.
Any off groups or shifts?
No, Madam Clerk, thank you.
Tuesday. Tuesday, March 15th at 1:30 p.m. for a preliminary hearing in prelim court.
All right, so that's your next court date for preliminary hearing. You'll be appointed a lawyer before then, and you'll be produced for that hearing by Zoom if you're in custody. So that concludes your initial appearance today. You can let them know on your floor that you're able to go back to your pod now. And if you need, we can call up there. Are you in a wheelchair? You are. Okay, he's nodding his head. All right, we'll call and have someone come and get you.
Be safe, sir.